Hey there guys, and welcome back to more Tales of Beseria. Last episode, I grinded a shit ton. Mostly because I ended up having to grind because this game does not like you, okay? And I did have to grind a little bit because of the fact that this place will kick your face in if you're underleveled. So, off camera, I did some grinding. Well, a lot of it. I went up like maybe 10 levels each character. Or something shit. Let's just say I had a lot of music playing when I was doing this because I was like half asleep last night. And I was playing it was Yu-Gi-Oh! Duel Links. And then Fire Emblem Heroes that everybody's been talking about. It's like the day after it releases, so yeah, that game is actually pretty goddamn fun. The only downside is Tharge is overpowered as fuck. Cause I got her on my first roll, and she's overpowered as fuck. Like, she starts out with freaking, I forgot what it was called, but I just gave her Vengeance, so that's a thing.
These ruins. This feels like a sad place.
Sad? In what way?
Sorrow permeates this place. As if left behind by people who suffered torment and death. I guess that's a weird impression to get by just looking at some ruins, huh?
I'd trust my feelings if I were you. They'll often lead you to the truth of things. Besides, what you're feeling would explain a thing or two about these ruins.
It would?
Rather than attempting to impress visitors with beauty and opulence, the building and its passageways were built with strength and stability in mind. And that means...
They were anticipating volcanic earthquakes, and they expected that someone might turn violent in these passageways.
Not a bad observation. And what would bring such savage people to these halls? Surely they weren't just passing through.
Then this passage must have led to somewhere. Some room or structure deeper within. A prison for the worst criminals. Or maybe a battle arena.
And that's what gave you a sense of sadness.
If it was an arena, then treasure for the victors might be hidden away somewhere.
Why would it be hidden?
Well, those fighter types might not have been all that nice. And the people who built this place seem to have been the cautious type.
Hidden treasure, huh? Where do you think,
Save your speculation for another day, you two. We have a Therian to find.
Right. Sorry.
So, about that treasure.
Aizen!
Dang it.
We'll talk about this later, Lafayette.
Alright.
Dang it. Aizen wants that treasure, though. Like, he's like, fuck you, man. I want that treasure. Alright. Nothing over there that we can get to. What's this? Red lavender. Get the fuck away from me. Can I just grab that? Norman?
This Nordahl. It looks a lot like Grimoire and Bienfu, but...
I agree. Those two are positively gloomy, but this doll seems calming, yet glamorous.
Like I said, a quiet radiance.
Yeah. You think so? I think it's more lethargic or absent-minded. Like it can't tell what's going on in its head. Either way, I'm 1,000 times cuter than that thing.
What's cute about you? People who keep their faces covered are creepy. I don't know. There's definitely something off about it. It's charming, but a little ominous. Like I can never entirely be at ease around it.
You think so? Actually, I think it's cute. It reminds me of a little baby.
You think this looks like a baby?
I remember when my sister was about as small as that doll. She had the tiniest little hands, and she tried to grip my pinky as best she could.
Really?
I'd take my pinky with her fingers wrapped around it and poke her cheek, and she'd just be all smiles. I swore to myself I'd always do whatever I could to protect her. Once she got a little older and started fixing meals, lots of weird things began to happen around us. Wherever we went, she was in danger. Demons attacked us. A dragon tried to kidnap her. That's when I first realized what it was that I carried. That the cause of all my sister's pain was my blessing, my Reaper's curse.
So, you left her behind and went on your search for a way to break the curse.
Right. And that's when I met Eifried. It was from him that I first heard about the Nordals. He thought the stories about them were all just baseless rumors.
I guess we'll never know for sure unless we gather them all. But...
Hmm?
I think something good will happen once they're all together.
Why do you say that?
Well, because we found this doll, you shared some of your past with us. That makes me kinda happy. So I think we should get the other three, so more happy stuff happens.
Hard to argue with you there.
Bobby said, you optimist. Alright, but yeah, I really do need to actually start collecting these things. Cause I might do that off camera. Collect them all, and if there's something cool happens, I'll record it. But if not, then I'll just leave it alone. Oh, Saturn Satchel. Yeah, that's better than what he had. Attack-wise, but... How is he the one with the most attack, even though he's a mage type? What the fuck? What kind of bullshit is that? Okay, but yeah, we really need to start getting going. Ramen English. English, motherfucker. Do you speak it? Dude, I need to rewatch that movie, actually. Yeah, I forgot I can't go down there. Oh, fuck.
Don't waste my time.
Leave this to me.
Power. There we go.
Come on, really?
Expedition return.
Scout.
I'm not letting them leave until I get that get the treasure for that island. It's not happening. Alright, but for real, I need to start actually trying to avoid some battles, because some battles tend to make the video drag on a lot longer than it needs to be. I know I can just edit it out, but good lord, some of these battles do drag on a little bit.
Very well. Onward.
Actually, no, fuck that shit.
Understood. Let's do-
This has always been my fight.
Oh-hoo! Miss me that much, did ya?
Just gonna play as Eleanor for a little bit, just to appease a certain someone who, for some odd reason, loves Eleanor. Probably because she uses a spear or something, I don't know. He knows who he is. Okay, what the fuck? What's up here? Oh, there's a Earth pulse tree. Moving at speed of sound. Some decent equipment at least. Yep. Why am I thinking of freaking Sonic? Oh. Yeah, bats are really not that much of a threat. What the hell? Okay, yeah, she needs something new. She has a lot of cool arts, but nothing I really care for, but whatever. We'll do healing circle. Fairy circle.
When it's pain, it's better to give than receive.
Too slow.
Oh my lord, the casting times.
You're all about to get a lot closer! No escape! No trouble! No escape!
What in the world?
Take this to me! Call and serpent! Let him out! Here I come! Call and serpent!
Right?
Strike the hobbit! Call and serpent! Here I come! Clamping lamp! Here I come! Who's next?
There we go.
You're just lucky I made it quick.
Yeah, there are things worse than death.
Edgy! No, but for real, we need to start moving. I'm trying to get used to using the geoboard more. Because I think there's an achievement for continuously using the geoboard. That's why I keep using it. And no, it's totally not because I actually use skateboard in real life. A little bit. Not as much as people would think I do, but not as much. Oh, my angsty teen essences. Son of a bitch. Oh, wow. We need to run.
I'll help you! Run for your head! Ow! I'll help you! I won't go easy on you!
Come on, run, bitch. Yeah, that was getting pretty bad. I don't want to fight ghosts and suits of armor at the same time. Because they hit like a frickin' truck. That's weird. What the?
Don't get careless!
Oh, man.
When it comes to pain, it's better to give than receive! We need to retreat!
Like, they pop out of fucking nowhere and it gets annoying after a while. Like, it's not even that, oh, I didn't see where I was going. It's more like, no, they're just getting annoying. And, gonna go grab that. Yeah, they give you a good chunk of capsules.
I'm up.
Watch, and I'll show you my Rangetsu style.
Right. You've got my support.
All right, so it looks like we're going to be fighting...
Yeah,
No mercy! Wounds that won't heal! Fire up with left! Leap of pain! Twin weapon! Crash through!
Is it hot?
Yeah, we need to get rid of the spellcaster. Oh my gosh. These are cane
bombs.
Yeah, this fight can get a little annoying. The exorcists are pretty freaking easy. It's more or less the demons that they summon is annoying. See that shit. That shit right there is annoying. Yeah, this can get very annoying very quickly. Oh my god, this fight. Done.
I refuse to fall here. So, Medissa really is here.
But what's this about the truth and controlling her?
Oh my god. Okay, I don't...
You better be ready.
I'm not butthurt, but... these freaking things get on my nerves. So, apparently... Okay, so your health does regen if you win a fight. But if you escape from a fight, you don't get any HP back. That's good to know. Yeah, fuck these guys. If I were a higher level, maybe this wouldn't be a problem. But yeah, the suit of armor is annoying. Because power armor like a motherfucker. There we go. Now we can move on. Fucking why? Alright. Shit. And there goes the last one.
A barrier! She's a Therian!
Third time's the charm, eh, kid?
Yeah.
You're Medissa?
I am. And who might you be?
We're like you. We carry grudges against the Abbey. And Shepherd Artorias.
It's gonna be okay. We came to get you out of here, Medissa.
There's no escape.
What? Please, don't give up. I can-
No, you don't understand. There's no escape. For you. If you dare sully Shepherd Artorias' ideals and the light the Abbey shines upon the world.
Oh, Lord.
I will kill you all!
This is gonna be fun.
Why are you doing this?
She's the Abbey's lucky now.
Way to jinx it, Rokuro.
Twin whip!
Is she continuously summoning things?
That's all, huh?
You're all about to get
let's go!
Crash through! Devour!
They just keep coming!
That snake woman keeps summoning them. If we don't go after her directly, there'll be no end to it.
Your left hand. Don't tell me you're the Calamity.
Why are you doing this, Medissa? Why fight for the Abbey after they forced you to become a Therian?
They didn't. I became one of my own free will.
But your daughter, slain at an exorcist's hands! You must hate the Abbey for that, don't you?
Oh, I feel hate. Toward a world where demons spawn from the people's malevolence!
You know about malevolence?
The exorcist told me the truth. Diana turned into a demon because of the malevolence she radiated. I knew what I had to do. Become a Therian, and devour malevolence so that such a tragedy would never repeat itself.
We're gonna have to kill her, aren't we?
It matters not what dreadful form my body may take. I will revive Enomenot and change this wretched world!
If that's how it is, fine. We'll take you by force.
Paint the town red!
Going to end this! Her death will not be in vain!
This woman! She's just a grieving mother!
It doesn't matter!
Crush them all!
Resist to me! Grieving mother my ass! Feel the Baby mother or not, she's still gonna have to go down like the rest.
No mercy!
Wounds that won't heal!
Make them pay! Take that!
Now we can stop her petrifying crap.
Take that!
She can't stop the. She can't stop me. Yeah, she's not stopping me.
Not good.
She's not gonna stop me from beating the crap out of her.
I enter the fray. Hurricane, killing flash.
When I'm this close,
I won't miss. Form zero. Thunder.
That's gonna get annoying. I don't know why she's.
Protect yourself! I will hit it with all you have!
Oh my god, man.
I grant eternal rest!
Now this is gonna be.
Let's
have it. Yeah, I ain't getting knocked around by that.
Velvet, enough
I didn't even see that. Alright, now I just take care of her snakes. Ah, that combos.
It's over. Curse you, Lord of Calamity.
Hey, she's Lord of Calamity. Hey, Lord of Calamity, Velvet.
Lord of Calamity. That's the name of the demon lord who will bring about the Age of Chaos. The unrepentant embodiment of malevolence, whose blind pursuit of self-gratification will rain destruction upon the world. The irredeemable, uncontrollable personification of human sins. An evil like you!
Demon, Therian, Lord of Calamity, call me whatever you like. But if I'm the supposed Lord of Demons, then you're just a minion to be used as I please. Nothing more.
No, I refuse. What happened to my Diana was my fault. That's why I will fight you until my dying breath!
Stop!
Don't get in my way!
No! Enough mothers have died. I won't let you join them!
Eleanor and Kamawana, they both lost their mothers too. It's a terrible thing.
Well, damn.
Kamawana?
A little girl that the Abbey forcefully made into a Therian. Her mother tried to save her, but she failed. All she could do was to offer her own life to fill her child's empty stomach.
Kamawana's been crying ever since. She misses her mother. If you die here, I can only imagine how sad that would make your Diana.
Diana!
You don't need me anymore, Mom. I get it. You love this new dad more than your own daughter!
No, honey. I did it for you. But you really thought I stopped loving you. And the malevolence made you into a demon. It's all my fault. I'm so sorry. Forgive me, Diana.
Medissa.
She'll be all right. She's just unconscious.
Let's grab her and haul her back.
I'll place her under a binding arc, just in case.
Gotta hand it to the Abbey. Very resourceful, taking advantage of Medissa's regrets like that. Making her into a Therian who would do their bidding.
It's just so cruel.
Who cares? Reason above all, no?
It's true. The way I feel goes against all reason. There's no telling what'll happen to Helifis once we take Medissa out of here. And yet I'm doing exactly that, all on account of my own hang-ups, even crushing Medissa's honest resolve.
According to reason, malevolence is the fault of the individual. You assume no responsibility or guilt for what happens to them.
I refuse to turn a blind eye to the consequences of my actions. I chose this path to seek the truth, not to deny it. If I'm to betray reason, then that is the very least I should do.
You're too much, you know that? You and Medissa both. Quit overthinking things. Just blame all the suffering on the Lord of Calamity. Makes life easier.
Velvet,
I'm not trying to cheer you up. I'm just saying it doesn't bother me. Whatever's coming, I can handle it.
God dang! But yeah, so... she's officially the Lord of Calamity. Return to Titania.
Hey, Eleanor. I was wondering, do you think I hurt Medissa saying that stuff to her?
I suppose you might have, but I was thinking the exact same things you were. Losing a mother. It's always a tragedy. I'm glad you stepped in and stopped her.
Thanks.
That Eleanor. I swear, she feels way more responsibility for everything than she needs to. You think we need to worry? What if she pushes too far and erupts with malevolence?
Malevolence is born out of many things. A prideful ego. The self-righteousness that turns a blind eye to one's inner contradictions. Eleanor is different. She's mindful of her ego, and strives to confront her inconsistencies of character.
She has a purity of heart that won't be tainted by the emotions that create malevolence. No other quality is as essential for an exorcist.
So she's probably okay?
For now, at least. But human, who knows what the future holds?
I doubt you got anything to worry about. For most exorcists, purity is a construct of the Abbey's teachings. But Eleanor, she's the real deal.
She's not your average exorcist, I'll give you that.
Purity is handy for any exorcist. But more than that, it's a rare and precious temperament for living. Everybody's got an ego and certain internal contradictions to some degree. Facing one's own ugliness in an honest manner is never easy. To be a normal human is to live carrying malevolence. It's just how much you let it control you that varies.
I guess malevolence might just be a fact of life, huh? But Artorias can't accept that.
Nice. Now we can go back. What the fuck? Why can't we go back to Tyson? Which way to the port? We gotta make our way through here, don't we?
Well, I don't see anything out of the ordinary. Let's slip through town and head for Titania before that changes. So this is your secret hideout. Once I get free, he won't stand a chance. You all had better sleep with one eye open. Look how worried I am.
Welcome back!
That's Kamuana.
She's the same age as Diana. Did the Abbey really turn someone so young into a Therian?
No shit, Sherlock. God, her voice.
Eleanor!
Medissa, please, would you be able to talk to her? Is this a trick? Kamuana may be a Therian, but deep down, she's still a normal little girl who misses her mother. I can't do anything to console her, no matter what I try. But if it were you...
Because you have bigger boobs.
You okay? You can call me Medissa, all right? Do I scare you, honey?
A little... But not as much as Velvet and Dial. But don't you think I'm scary? I had a bad dream earlier. My mommy said I looked scary and that she didn't want me anymore.
I will suffocate you with my boobs.
She would never. Your mother would never think that about her daughter.
But how do you know?
Because I'm a mother too. Mothers always love their children, no matter what. No matter if we die. No matter how the world changes. There's nobody who loves you more in the world than...
It's okay. You don't have to cry.
I hope Kamuana and Medissa won't have to feel so lonely anymore.
Yeah. Trying to stop the waterworks gets old fast.
Listen, if it's not too personal, was your mother,
She's dead. I lost her when I was even younger than you.
Oh. I'm sorry to hear that.
It's fine. It just means we've got things in common. So no feeling sad and alone, okay?
Oh, no, I'm fine. I don't feel lonely or anything, I swear.
What's gotten into you? You're so strange sometimes.
No, I'm not.
He's got a thing for you. Is it that hard to tell?
Eleanor, I'll have you watch over Kamuana and Medissa.
Yes, of course. I'd be honored. Thank you.
Are exorcists supposed to be so polite to a grand poobah of Calamity or whatever?
Sure, why not? Besides, the Demon Lord ought to not trouble herself over such trivialities.
Velvet, Grimoire's calling for you. She says to bring Lafayette and meet her at the Observation Tower.
Got it.
We better get going then.
Can I teleport? Damn it. I gotta go all the way up there to the Observation Tower. The Lord of Calamity shouldn't have to run or walk. Whatever. We already got the data for this area, so we can just keep moving up.
Hey, do you all have mothers?
Hmm? Where'd that question come from?
Well, after hearing that Velvet, Kamuana, and Eleanor all lost their parents, I just got curious.
My mother was a strict, frightening woman, but she died a long time ago.
I see.
I have no parents either, but the wicked witch who took me in said I was born from a peach that floated down the river.
Coming from you, I'd almost believe that.
And you, Aizen?
We Malakim are formed from untainted mana. Sometimes humans are reborn as Malakim, but they retain no memory of their previous lives. In other words, we don't have blood relations like humans do.
I see. By the time I was aware of anything around me, I was already tethered and being called number two. I suppose having no mother means I don't have any memories before that. I told Medissa that losing a mother is painful, but I can't know how painful it is.
Go easy on him, Aizen. He's just a kid.
I'm just telling it like it is. But listen to me, Lafayette. You can share deep connections with other people, even if you don't have a biological family. Malakim, too, can form precious bonds, true friendships, even family.
That's right. Your words wouldn't have stopped Medissa if they weren't true in your heart.
You really think so?
I'm sure of it.
It's far better than being a witch born from a peach.
Nonsense! There's no nobler way to be born! I have an everlasting friendship with a dog, a monkey, a pheasant, and Bienfu.
I hope he's right.
Aww. That was kind of cute. Though, oddly enough, I had a feeling that they all didn't have parents. I mean, Shigure seems to be Rokuro's only family. Even though they're trying to kill each other, but whatever.
You said that Malakim can have familial ties, but what makes you and your sister siblings if you're not related by blood?
Well, a very long time ago, I was born into this world from an earth pulse point up on a sacred mountain. I remained in that place for a long while, and then one day, she was born from the very same earth pulse point. Before we knew it, we had wound up living together under the same roof.
Are two Malakim always siblings if they come from the same earth pulse point?
No. Other Malakim were born there, but I never felt like they were my family. But something, I don't know what, was different with her. If she was sad, I'd feel sad. And if I was happy, she'd be happy too. She can be abrasive, but when she smiles, it's like nothing else. I swore to myself that whatever happened, I would protect her. I made a pendant from a stone on that sacred mountain and gave it to her as a lucky charm. Of course, she just wears it as a necklace.
And your pendant? Did she give that to you?
Aww, that's cute.
She had the same idea I had. She made the pendant herself and gave it to me as a good luck charm. Without either of us having mentioned a word of it beforehand, we each gave each other pendants in the same shape on the very same day. That's when I really knew that what I had felt all along was true. We were brother and sister.
Is that her in the picture?
Yeah. It's a self-portrait she drew for me on the day I left home.
Did you draw her a picture of yourself?
No. I don't exactly have an artistic side.
Well, I'm sure that if you looked inside her pendant, you'd find a portrait of the person who matters most to her.
I hope so.
Yeah, and it would be nice if it was you.
Magilu, you might want to watch what you say, because he will probably kill you.
Ah, there you two are.
Hi, teacher. Have you made progress deciphering the book?
I have indeed. It turns out there was a second counting song. I've already transcribed it. Would you read it aloud for us, child?
Okay. When the eight malevolences overflow, in the culmination of mankind's despair, Ennomenot will bring an end to all peoples and restore them to time immemorial. Four Empyreans shall wield a wrathful sword and cleave the great devourer, two asunder to sleep beneath the earth, as scarlet moonlight illuminates the evil. The nameless Empyrean hath one heart. The nameless Empyrean hath one body.
Oh, yet more delightful material to keep us awake at night.
If I'm understanding this right, it's discussing the specific nature of Ennomenot? That's what I believe, yes. When the eight malevolences overflow in the culmination of mankind's despair, Ennomenot will bring an end to all peoples.
So, when the world is at peak malevolence, Ennomenot will use that power to bring an end to all. Is that it?
He's going to wipe out all of humanity?
Is that what the Abbey is after? Is that why they've been trying to bring back Ennomenot?
No. Artorias is not that kind of man.
Really? Now you're defending him?
His two primary ideals are the many over one, and the restoration of order through will and reason. He sacrificed Lofi to protect this world, not to eradicate it.
You mean that's who he is as far as you know, yeah? People change, Velvet. Perhaps the Shepherd gave up hope. Maybe he lost faith in mankind. Fools prone to sin, endlessly generating malevolence.
He's not like that. If that's all true, then what point was there in Lofi's death?
Is there anything else in that book?
Yes and no. This copy itself is incomplete. There ought to be further pages, but they're missing. For now, I've done all I can.
There must be an original somewhere, right?
Without it, I doubt the Abbey would be plotting Ennomenot's revival. We can be sure they have complete understanding of their Empyrean's nature.
But this was the only copy in the Royal Villa. If the original is out there, who knows where it could be?
It's getting pretty late. Why don't we call it a day?
Yeah, let's get some rest.
I'm thinking that might have been Lofi Set's book that we found. Because I remember in the beginning of the game they said before that, that Lofi Set made a copy of it.
Hey, Lofi Set! Medessa let me sleep in her bed last night! She's warm for a snake lady!
That's great!
She's gonna help me take a bath now. You should come join us, too.
Oh, my lord. Lofi said you better say yes.
What? I couldn't. It's okay. I don't mind at all.
Hey, Kamalana. Did you know? Dial started to grow a brand new tail.
Wow, really? I want to see.
He's up at the observation tower.
Let's go see! Medessa, you too!
Alright. But don't run, or you'll trip.
Thanks, Eleanor. I appreciate it.
Having some girl trouble, my little Malik?
I'm just glad Kamawana and Medissa are starting to feel better.
Yeah, they both still have a long way to go, but it's such a relief to see them smiling.
We've got bigger things to worry about. Hurry up and locate the next Earth Pulse point.
Right. Okay.
Must you always be so blunt, Velvet?
I must, in fact. We're up against the Abbey here, and sooner or later they'll find this place.
That's true. But still...
Do we go find another hideout?
No. We'll keep on the offensive. We'll capture the remaining Therians before the Abbey finds us.
As a swordsman, I can respect that mindset.
I'm not so sure we could hold this place anyway.
We've got no obligation to.
I found another Earth Pulse point. It's in the eastern part of East Gand, I think.
But that's... All right. We're headed for East Gand.
Then our first stop should be Port Taliesin.
I think... Wasn't that Velvet's home?
Grimoire always looks like she never wants to do any work, but despite all her grumbling, when she starts a job, she gets it done. And quickly, too. She's frank, but she still takes care not to say anything to hurt anyone's feelings.
Well, sorry if I'm inconsiderate and charmless, then.
I didn't mean it like...
Roker...
When man...
So that's no man... Under... Maybe that is a...
We don't have...
And don't forget... Not that I really care, but who...
Man, that was a while ago. I lost because I came away with...
No, it was a draw. As I'm sure everyone remembers, all I fished up were octopus demons. We were competing over...
This island's really something. No way I'd want to go to prison here, but it'd make a great hideout. If I'm gonna be left in charge...
You're in charge?
Someone has to look after this place. I'll keep this...
But those are just...
You dolt! These are important. We've got another navigator. But is there anyone besides me that could handle all of the besides? Ever since I lost my tail, my balance has been off.
That's your story and you're sticking to it?
No.
Hey, get this! I was out once I realized-
Was it a sudden-
I wish-
Yeah, another class 4-
A huge-
Alright, so now we got another class 4, place to go to. So now we got that, we're gonna talk to Gaio and Dial.
It's sour.
So you've kept your sense of taste.
In my dreams, I have. Nowhere else.
Does that make this a dream?
It would have to be, wouldn't it? After all. I devoured you.
That's right. Don't you go forgetting it.
How could I ever forget it? The taste of your... How could I ever...
Looks like the fog's rolling in.
Yep.
Eleanor, there's something I want to be sure we get perfectly clear.
All right. What is it?
Lafayette is not your little Moloch.
What? That's all you wanted to say? You realize he doesn't belong to you either, right?
Indeed I do. Lafayette's his own person, and not anyone else's.
You're right. Malakim aren't just tools to be used by exorcists as they pleased. I'll be more careful not to forget that.
Good. As long as we're on the same page.
Since we're on the subject of reminders, you haven't forgotten our little bet, have you, Velvet?
You mean the 100 gold on whether I'd break? No, I haven't forgotten.
A word of caution. People can fight against pain, but they can't fight against happiness. If you're keen on winning our bet, I'd steer clear of ill-fitting dreams.
Sorry to break it to you, But all I have anymore are nightmares. The fog's cleared. Good thing we didn't wind up getting lost in it.
Of course we didn't. Who do you think is running this ship?
A bunch of shameless rogues who are very good at shameless roguery.
Damn straight.
But it's strange. These waters don't usually see much fog.
Wasn't this the... Huh. I still imagined it. Thought there'd be an Earth Pulse point somewhere around this area. But I guess not.
Whoa! It's like a castle!
This used to be the base of operations for a rich trading family. When trouble came knocking, they were ready for it, to say the least.
Wow! They must have had a lot of enemies.
But that was a long time ago. Nowadays, it's just another town in the middle of nowhere. But even so, to us, it was the big city of our dreams.
You know this area well.
I grew up near here. Keep on going, and you'll run into a ball. My home village.
Then, the Therian is...
Yeah, somewhere in my village.
Is that okay?
No one will know me there. Everyone I knew, I already devoured.